Good evening. Welcome to Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church. Today we celebrate the 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time. A reminder to all parents, as a precaution during coronavirus, the cry room for small children is closed. We ask you to please accompany your child to the restroom if they need to go. At this time, please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Our celebrant today is Father Brandon. We begin by praying together the Diocesan Prayer of Vocations. Please stand. O God, hear our prayers, and let our cry come unto you.
Bless our Diocese of Savannah with many vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Give the men and women you call the light to understand your gift and the love to follow always in the footsteps of your priestly Son. Amen.
Please join in singing the introductory song, number 594, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Amen. We welcome you this evening to Blessed Sacrament. This is Father's Day weekend, so we're going to pray in a special way for all of our fathers, both living and deceased. We ask God's blessing upon them, and we thank God for them. And also tonight, especially at this Mass, we have three of our younger children who are going to be receiving their first Holy Communion. And we also have around 13 of our graduating eighth graders that are now going to be receiving the sacrament of confirmation. So we pray for them in a special way tonight as they receive these very important sacraments of initiation. So let us prepare ourselves as we bow our heads and we ask God's forgiveness of our sins.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
right hand of the Father, have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Lord, like Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped, then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble, they will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame, to lasting, unforgettable confusion. O Lord of hosts, you who test the just, who probe mind and heart, let me witness the vengeance you take on them, for to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, through one man sin entered the world, and through sin death. And thus death came to all men, inasmuch as all sinned. For up to the time of the law, sin was in the world, though sin is not accounted when there is no law. But death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those who did not sin after the pattern of the trespass of Adam, who is the type of the one who was to come. But the gift is not like the transgression. For if by the transgression of the one the many died, how much more did the grace of God and the gracious gift of the one man, Jesus Christ, overflow for the many? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs on your head are counted. So be not be afraid. You are worth more than the sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. So we welcome you all, and especially family and visitors from family of those receiving their First Communion or Confirmation. We're happy to have you all today to Blessed Sacrament. It's a little disheveled, shall we say, because of the virus and everything that's happened. But nonetheless, today, three of our second graders, now your third graders, right, are going to receive their first Holy Communion, the Body and Blood of Jesus, and 13 of our young people, now graduates, will receive the sacrament of confirmation. And so I want to talk to you, our first communicants first, and then I'm going to ask our confirmandi to come up. And I'm going to ask you just to stand on the first step, and we'll get your sponsors up in just a moment. But first we're going to get you up here and answer a few questions. So first of all, what is Holy Communion? Tell us, what have you learned?
That you get the body and blood of Christ.
Hold on, I got the wrong microphone. This is when you're wired for television. Tell me again.
It's when you get the body of Jesus.
The body of Jesus, the body and blood of Jesus. And when you receive the body and blood of Jesus, what happens inside your soul, do you think? It does heal you. You're exactly right. When we receive Holy Communion, it washes away our sins. It fills us with grace. It makes us one with Jesus Christ. That's a good thing to be, isn't it? And so you're excited about receiving your first Holy Communion?
Kind of.
Kind of? Yeah. Are you a little nervous as well? What makes you nervous?
I don't know.
Not sure? But to receive the body and blood of Christ for the first time, ever since your baptism, you know, I baptized you. I've been here a long time. Ever since you were baptized, the Holy Spirit, God the Father, Son, and Spirit, came and lived and moved into your soul. Did you know that? And God has been living inside your soul, one with you. But you don't really feel Him, do you? But He's there. And then you'll receive the sacrament. So baptism was your first. Then you receive Holy Communion today. You're going to be one with Jesus now, not just spiritually, but also physically, because Jesus is the God-man, isn't He? He was a human as well as God, together in one person. And so this is a whole new way to be one with the Lord. And then the third way is what our graduating eighth graders, I don't know what to call you, ninth graders, because you now receive the third sacrament of initiation that makes you fully an adult member of the Catholic Church. So that's wonderful that we have all the sacraments represented here. So we invite our confirmandi to come forward now. And on the first step, are you ready for confirmation? Just stand on the first step and face the congregation, please. You mean they only let one boy come tonight? I can't. Girls always do that to these boys. So first of all, we're very excited, and we love you very much. We're proud of you. I'm going to start with the boy, since he's the only one. You're pretty brave to come up here with all these girls. So what do you like best, Liam? What do you just like best about your Catholic faith?
I guess the faith, you get, you're one with God and stuff, and we have close family.
Your close family and friends that are filled with faith with you. Yeah. All right. Who's your patron saint?
Saint Peregrine.
Saint Peregrine.
I don't know how to say his.
That's okay. What's Saint Peregrine the patron saint of?
Cancer patients.
Cancer patients. Why did you choose the patron saint of cancer patients?
Because my grandma had cancer.
Okay. So you believe in her prayer, in his prayers for your grandmother, and Just to pray for that terrible disease, right? Very good. Do you think you're going to feel anything of the sacrament of confirmation?
I don't know.
Not sure? But do it happen? Do you think something's going to change inside of you?
Yes.
What's going to happen?
Like we're going to be cleansed by God.
Cleansed. Who do you receive in confirmation?
The Holy Spirit.
In a way that you've never received the Holy Spirit before. Again, I've always, thing that we talk about all the time is Christianity is about a relationship with Jesus, right? And not up to now, your relationship has kind of been mom and dad kind of made it happen, right? They said their night prayers with you, and they took you to church on Sunday. But as you grow up, now your relationship has to be your decision, right? Are you ready to have a relationship with Jesus? Even without your mom and dad pushing you?
Yes.
It's just your decision to receive confirmation.
Yes.
Good. And the strength that God will give you today will prepare you. Holy Spirit, when people receive confirmation, something is going to change in your soul. When I received it, I couldn't feel anything. I walked out kind of disappointed. Like, I thought I would have felt something. But over the next several years, even in college, I realized something big had changed inside of me. Sacrament of confirmation changes your soul permanently and prepares you to really take a stand for Christ. The deacon just read the gospel and said, if we don't stand up for Jesus Christ, right? That's what he expects us to do. To say that we believe in him in this world? What do you hope for in your life? What are your dreams? You weren't expecting that question. What do you hope for? Want to come back to you? Okay. What do you hope for in your life?
I want to be successful.
Mm-hmm. Define it. Tell me about Saint Bernadette.
She had visions of Mary, and she dug a grotto in Lourdes that is now a pilgrimage to Catholics.
Yes. And why did you choose Saint Bernadette to be your patron saint?
Because she's the patron saint of the ill.
Of the ill. Okay. So it's the patron saint of sick people, because Lourdes is a place where people go to be healed. What's your favorite scripture? Your favorite story from the Bible, your favorite scripture passage?
It probably has to be whenever St. Peter walked on water and then he lost faith and he sunk, and then Jesus said, "You have little faith."
That's a great story, isn't it? And Jesus is walking on the water in the middle of a storm, and then why did he start sinking?
Because he lost faith.
And he took his eyes off
Jesus.
Yeah, he took his eyes off Jesus and he started sinking, right? And that's what St. Teresa of Avila says, the only mistake we ever make is taking our eyes off of Jesus. So, we're not going to take our eyes off of Jesus, are we? And what we want you very much is to have a relationship with Jesus Christ that will sustain you and protect you and keep you safe. You know that He loves you, right? Yes. The gospel just said He knows how many hairs on your head. You've got a lot of hairs on your head. Do you know Jesus knows how many hairs you have on your head? And you're worth, each one of you is worth more than everything else God created put together. Every one of you is more valuable than all the animals and plants in the world, because you are made in the image and likeness of God. Isn't that marvelous? And that's why remember that Blessed Sacrament truth statement I kept saying to you in our religion lessons online? Do you remember it? Can you quote it, Sarah? Can you remember? I am a child of God. Remember that? I'm a child of... you want to say it? So I teach them this little prayer. It goes like this. I am a child of God. I am a temple of the Holy Spirit. I am made in the image and likeness of God for my own sake. I can never be used. I can never be discarded. The only acceptable response is love. And that is true about you. And it's also true about every other person in this world. So when you look at another person, you say, he or she is a child of God, a temple of the Holy Spirit. He or she is made in the image and likeness of God for his own sake or her own sake. Can never be used. Can never be discarded. The only acceptable response is love. Wouldn't that be wonderful if everybody in the world treated everybody else that way? And that's what Jesus has the power to do if you keep him in your life. I said my goal for... I always say my goal for you is that you wake up in 20 years and you will wake up and say, I'm very proud of the person I've become. You will become a Christian lady, a Christian gentleman. And that's our goal for you. So, you ready to receive the sacrament of confirmation? Who did I not ask any questions to? Who's your patron saint? Saint Anthony. Why Saint Anthony? He was a Franciscan, right? Yeah. And what is he the patron saint of? He's the patron saint of the poor, but also of things that are lost. He's very helpful in that as well. Okay. I'm going to invite our sponsors to come forward. And I want you guys to step down and turn around and face the altar. We're lopsided. Everybody move that way. All right. step down on the one step. Turn and face me. On the day of Pentecost, the apostles received the Holy Spirit as the Lord had promised. They also received the power of giving the Holy Spirit to others and so completing the work of baptism. We read this in the Acts of the Apostles when St. Paul placed his hands on those who had been baptized. The Holy Spirit came upon them and they began to speak in other languages and tongues. Our bishops are successors of the apostles, and they have this power of giving the Holy Spirit to the baptized, either personally or through the priests they appoint. In our day, the coming of the Holy Spirit in confirmation is not just marked by the gift of tongues. He fills our hearts with the love of God. He brings us together in one faith, but in different vocations, and works within us to make the church holy. The gift of the Holy Spirit, which you are about to receive, will be a spiritual sign and seal to make you more like Christ and more perfect members of His church. You have already been baptized into Christ, and now you will receive the power of the Spirit and the sign of the cross on your forehead. You must be witnesses before all the world to His suffering, death, and resurrection, and your way of life should reflect the goodness of Jesus Christ. Be active members of the church and live alive in Jesus Christ. And under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, give your lives completely in the service of all, as did Jesus, who came not to be served, but to serve. So now, before you receive the Holy Spirit, I ask you to renew the vows of your own baptism with your sponsors, your parents, godparents, and I invite all to stand. Answer the questions I do. Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation? I do. This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. My dear friends, in baptism, God our Father gave the new birth, the eternal life, to His chosen sons and daughters. Let us pray to our Father that He will pour out the Holy Spirit upon these sons and daughters and make them more like His Son Jesus. All-powerful God, Father and Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, You freed Your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send Your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide, Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of right judgment and courage, of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the Spirit of wonder and awe in Your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. With the chrism. And sponsors, if you'll place your right hand on their shoulder. Jada, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Say amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. What's your name, Doug? Kate. Kate, what's your patron saint? Kate, Mother Teresa of Calcutta, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. What's the first name? Allie, Joan of Arc. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. Abby Catherine of Siena. be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. Rosemary Magdalene, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Madeline St. Peregrine, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Mary Magdalene, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Liam St. Sebastian, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Say it with your spirit. Sarah St. Agnes, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Gigi St. Anthony, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. And with your spirit. Alexis St. Peter, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Finn St. Sebastian, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Sophie St. Bernadette, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. Lily St. Jude, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Say amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. Maddie St. Cecilia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Genevieve St. Margaret, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you, with your spirit. Where's the book? We congratulate the newly confirmed members of our of Saint Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church. You can return to your place now. We lift up our prayers now to God, our Almighty Father, for these young people, for our world, and all of our needs.
That all those who are set apart to preach, to teach, or to minister in the church will witness to Jesus Christ fearlessly and without compromise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who govern nations will protect human rights, further the work of justice, and advance the freedom of those in their charge. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are researching treatments and vaccines for dangerous illnesses, that God will guide and inspire their work so that life can be preserved. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all fathers and those who have shown us a father's love, that God will grant them good health, guide them in being good examples, and help them to be a source of encouragement to their children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the Lord Jesus may acknowledge before his Father in heaven our beloved departed, especially those whose anniversaries we celebrate this week. Carolyn Fisher and Antoinette Bowie, and for Donna Marie Davis, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our next bishop of the Diocese of Savannah, that he will please Almighty God with his holiness, instruct us by his virtues, and fill us with the truth of the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord. Father in heaven, we lift up these and all our prayers. With great confidence, we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, for he is Lord, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Please join in singing our offertory song, number 683, How Firm a Foundation.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept sacrifice, praise and glory of his name. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you come to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned a remedy from mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices join with theirs in one chorus of praise as we acclaim. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom, the power. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
take
away the sins of the world,
grant.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
We pray together now with those who are watching from home and not able to be present, our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you're truly present in the most blessed sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you. And since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I choose to be one with you, Lord. I want your heart next to my heart, your soul next to my soul. I want your infinite divinity to fill me completely, to be one with you in all that I say and do. Jesus, I love you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. This time we will invite our first communicants to come forward to receive the body and blood of Christ for the first time. Okay, let's go back down. Okay, let's line up one at a time, please. Okay. Good job. Step forward. The body of Christ. About a deacon. Sign of the cross. Good boy. Good job. The body of Christ. Drink it all. The body of Christ. Put it in your mouth. So I make the sign of the cross. Okay. Now bow down to precious blood. Third. Go get one more. Yeah. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Just get that corner out there, Dick. Step up.
Please join in singing our communion song, On Eagle's Wings.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Congratulations to all those who have entered the church over the last several weeks through our RCIA class, their first Holy Communions, confirmations. We're continuing, due to the coronavirus guidelines, to have individual or small group masses to receive these sacraments. So if your child is still scheduled to receive their one of these sacraments, please call the parish office and let us know. Congratulations to Father Bobby Phillips and Father Carlos Rivera, who were newly ordained priests today at the cathedral. They'll be serving in the Diocese of Savannah, so we welcome them, wish them many blessings. After the Masses this weekend, I'll be in the Breezeway area, kind of going away or welcome back to Mass celebration in order to be sensitive to our health concerns. People that are not comfortable can just drive by, and I'll be there in the Breezeway and can say goodbye to you. Tomorrow after the 10:30 Mass, we'll have an additional opportunity, a small social in the gymnasium, so for those that would like to be a part of that. Next weekend, June 27th and 28th, I will still be here. It'll be my last weekend here before our new pastor comes, Father David Cutter. But we will, after all the Masses, have special unveiling of original artwork of Blessed Sacrament for our 100th anniversary by Sharon Sassine, and an opportunity to meet with her and to see that after the Masses next weekend. Let us pray. If your Father is here present with you, I invite you, or place your hand on him now as we give a special blessing for our fathers. God, our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers, and let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, as their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Again, a special congratulations to our three new first communicants. We're very proud of you. And our 13, I think it was, those that received the sacrament of confirmation, congratulations on receiving these sacraments, and our confirmandi especially. And I will be available for photos. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 667, Faith of Our Fathers.